Hi, in this video, we're going to solve another problem, a series parallel circuit problem for REQ. And this example brings up that sometimes it's necessary, at least for some people, to redraw the circuit in order to see how a resistor is connected in a circuit. So let's look at this diagram at the very top of the page. This is our circuit, and you can see there's four resistors. Now, for a lot of people, it's hard to determine the way the circuit is drawn here, how this 45 ohm resistor is connected to the rest of the circuit. See, if that 45 ohm resistor was not there, okay, and that's what I did down here, is I just redrew the circuit without the 45, just to show that, well, if the 45 is not connected to the circuit, this is just one of those basic series parallel circuits that we saw last lecture. These two resistors here, okay, the 125, they're in parallel. If you just imagine a current flowing from where we're getting the REQ for, so if you just imagine a current flowing into that circle from where REQ is, well, once that current gets inside the circle, it has two paths. So that 100 and that 25 are in parallel, so if we did product over sum, we'd have 2500 divided by 125. Okay, so 20 ohms. So the 100 in parallel with, okay, that's my symbol for parallel, with the 25 gives us 20 ohms. And then that parallel combination is in series with the 10. So our REQ, if this was our circuit without the 45, would just be 30 ohms. One other thing here that I didn't point out earlier that's a good thing to know is that anytime you're getting the R equivalent for parallel resistors, the R equivalent will always be less than the smallest individual resistor. So you see, even before I go to calculate what the REQ of these two resistors are in parallel, I know the answer is going to be less than 25 ohms. And you see we got 20, so that's just a good check to keep in mind. Now, of course, it's possible to still make some sort of error where you know, the answer comes out less than 25 and it's still wrong, but at least if you get an answer greater than the smallest resistor value that you have in parallel, you know you definitely have an error somewhere. Okay? All right, but getting back to the main topic here is, well, you know, how is this 45 ohm resistor connected to the rest of the circuit? Because it's really hard. A lot of people, and I'll be honest, the first time I did this problem, I didn't first off see, you know, how this 45 is connected to the rest of the circuit with the circuit drawn like this. So what you can do is you can redraw a circuit, and as long as after you redraw the circuit, the resistors are still connected to the same nodes, then it's the same circuit. So you see here, see the 45 is connected to that node, and also the 45 is connected to this node. See all this. So I can redraw the 45 as this here. See, I can redraw the 45 like this. And you see, I haven't changed anything because in this diagram, the 45 is connected to the right side of the 10 ohm and also this top terminal here. That's what that little circle is. You know, just a terminal. In fact, you know, we could label it, say, A. So terminal A. Okay, and we could label this bottom one B. Okay, so you see in both diagrams, the 45 is connected to the same node on the top, and then as well as the bottom, because this node B here, that's all of this. Okay, so when I redraw it, it's still, see, it's still connected to the same two nodes as it was up in this diagram. But for most people, it's a lot easier to to now see how the 45 is connected to the rest of the circuit when it's drawn like this. Because as we did before, you know, we would still start with 125 in parallel, get 20, then add 10 to that. Okay, but now the 45 is in parallel with the rest of the circuit here. So you see REQ would equal 30 in parallel with the 45. Okay, and you know, this is only necessary, redrawing the circuit is only necessary if you have to do it. I mean, there are people, I'm not one of them, but there are people that they can see that this 45, when it's drawn like this, is in parallel with the rest of the resistors. But you know, if you need to, it's something to keep in mind. But what you have to remember when you redraw a circuit is that after you're done redrawing it, you got to make sure the resistors are still connected to the same nodes they were before you redrew it, because if after you redraw it the resistors are connected to different nodes, well then you have a different circuit. Okay, so you got to be careful, but it is something that you can do that can be very, very helpful sometimes. So just to finish this, to get a final answer here, product over sum with 30 and 45, let's see, 30 times 45 is that, and then divided by 75, we get an answer of 18 ohms. So you see that's our REQ for this problem. Our answer, 18 ohms. And you see that makes sense, because 18 is smaller than the smallest individual resistor in this parallel calculation here. So that makes sense. Okay.